Mechanism of Photosynthesis Part 2. How Carbon Dioxide Fixation Leads to Glucose Formation. Objectives: by the end of this video, you will be able to state three phases of dark reaction, explain the process of dark phase, and give reasons why it is called as light independent reaction and biosynthetic reaction. In light reaction, we have learnt about the requirements of photosynthesis, such as water molecule, sunlight as energy source, and chlorophyll pigment as a site of light reaction. We have also learnt about the formation of energy-rich compounds such as NADPH and ATP molecules. What about carbon dioxide? Doesn't it have any role in light reaction? No, it doesn't. It plays a major role in dark reaction, which occurs in the stroma of chloroplasts. Does dark reaction occur only in the darkness? It actually occurs at any time independent of light. Hence, it is known as light independent reaction. Of course, it is not a single step reaction. It involves several biochemical reactions. Hence, it is known as biosynthetic phase. The facts about biosynthetic phase had been revealed by Malvin Calvin, an American biochemist who was awarded with Nobel Prize for his work in this regard. He has described his research work in the form of Calvin cycle. Calvin cycle involves three steps: carboxylation, reduction, and regeneration. Carboxylation: for the formation of one glucose molecule, 6 carbon dioxide molecules are required. Does it mean 6 carbon dioxide molecules will combine together to form glucose? No, it is hardly possible. Then how is it made possible? It is made possible by involving several intermediary compounds as well as several intermediary biochemical reactions. The important substance is ribulose 1,6-biphosphate, which starts the process of carboxylation, that is carbon dioxide fixation. In this process, 6 carbon dioxide molecules containing 1 carbon atom each will combine with ribulose 1,6-biphosphate molecules which contain 5 carbon atoms. Totally, they make about 36 carbon atoms. This results in the formation of 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid which contain 3 carbon atoms each. Totally, they make about 36 carbon atoms. Reduction: in this process, phosphoglyceric acid molecules will be converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate molecules by utilizing 12 ATP molecules and 12 NADPH molecules. This is reduction process. Among 12 molecules, 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will be involved in the formation of fructose, which in turn form 1 molecule of glucose, which is a 6 carbon molecule. Regeneration: the remaining 10 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which make about 30 carbon atoms, will be involved in the regeneration process of RuBP by utilizing 6 ATP molecules in the process. Finally, 6 molecules of RuBP are formed in this process, and these will be made available for the next cycle to occur. This is how the Calvin cycle is represented with carboxylation process, reduction, and regeneration. Summary: in this video, we have explained dark reaction as well as explained as it is called as light independent reaction and biosynthetic phase.